Rather than knocking myths aside, I prefer the other approach of starting with culture is a complex concept, and that is its value. It captures everything that the group has learned, including how the group strategizes, including even the structure. The structure is, in fact, one of the most powerful elements of the culture. So anyone who says structure eats culture for breakfast, they just don't know what they're talking about.
Yeah.
One of the things that we try to do in the new book is make clear and quite explicit the distinctions between the deep underlying assumptions that really represent sort of the DNA of the culture, juxtaposed to the espoused values or what people say is important. So you may have that poster on the wall in the break room or the kitchen that talks about, you know, our values are for the year 2020, but because you just went through a reformulation process. But if those things are distinct from the underlying assumptions that came, you know, from the founder and evolved through the history of the company, you're still going to have those sort of gaps in what people who work at that company sort of perceive and believe about what it means to work there.
Figure out your problem first, and then examine all the elements of culture to see which ones will help you and which ones will hinder you.